download from Triple J. Triple J.
For more music, current affairs, comedy and culture, triplej.net.au.
And now...
Triple J.
Triple J.
Triple J.
Triple J Mornings with Zan.
George and I went to primary school together. And then we didn't see each other for about 6 years, and I went to high school with John. And then we re-met at schoolies, oddly enough, in a disgusting nightclub.
The wet t-shirt competition.
The wet t-shirt competition.
You met over a wet t-shirt competition.
We weren't the ones like cheering with erections in the front row. We were the ones at the back kind of
going, disclaimer.
This is disgusting.
And,
what is this? But you were still there.
The weirdest thing is...
What, like 20th century?
The weirdest part about the whole thing was that the women who were on stage were people we went to primary school with. So it was like, what's going on?
Yeah, it was like...
I've seen you in 8 years.
It all comes full circle.
So you're standing there in a massive school reunion of sorts, and the three of you have met up together again. How do you make the leap from... basically bare breasts to let's make music together? How does that happen?
I guess we just got to talking about what music we're listening to and about what we've been up to, and I guess it kind of felt like, we'll probably meet up. Everyone says they're going to meet up and make some music together, but it actually ended up happening. And
it was lucky as well, because when I met George at school, as we got chatting, we realized we live pretty much across the road from each other, so that probably helped, because it was like, I can't really see him. I can't not see him, because I can't see him leaving his front door every day.
I swear to God, I'm not at home, John. I've been so busy today.
But yeah, no, it was good actually, because completely coincidental that George had just bought an MPC. I'd just gotten a Micro Korg, and Alex had just gotten a sampler. So there were all these three instruments, and in a way we kind of had these roles. So as soon as we came together, it's like everything was fulfilled. Like, you do the beats, I'll do the melody, and Aka can just do weird noise stuff in the background.
The cheapest, electronic instruments you can buy from a store.
Yeah, they were the cheapest.
And we still use them.
Went in to record this second record, what was the aim? Did you have an idea or a bit of a blueprint of how the second CK record would sound like?
We wanted it to be like a cohesive piece of work, more so than the last record, which was a sort of a collection of tracks that we'd done over a couple of years. So we definitely want it to be one entire piece.
Yeah, I think we had a lot of different ideas of what we wanted it to sound like, and then lots of really strange kind of different ideas, and then it was kind of ended up being like just a summary of all of those ideas. So
we really wanted to start using organic instruments, so strings and clarinets and stuff like that. And I think it was 2 years ago or 3 years ago, we got given a grant by Sound Clash, so we were able to actually pay session musicians and hire these people to come in, and then just allowed us to explore territory that previously we just tried to do with computers, and now we're actually playing with kind of classical instruments and stuff like that. So yeah.
So it was more of a traditional recording environment that you found yourselves in?
Yeah, for certain songs, definitely. And we were more of a band. We are in both the way we compose songs and how we recorded the album and stuff. So it was very different to the first, for sure.
Who did you have on board? Who did you pay to appear on a CK record with these funds?
Well, we got these three strings players, just kind of got them to layer these tracks and make it sound like they were lots of strings players, but it's really only three. And we got a clarinetist, Alex Spence. We got Giselle, who did a song with the Cravey song.
Yeah, with Flight Facilities.
Yeah, we got her to do like a few things, she's throughout the record, like just vocal samples and stuff, not like a main.
So you got her to record a song, it's singing, and then you just cut it to shreds.
Pretty much. Like, it sounds pretty good, but if we put it through 100 effects, it sounds even better.
I wanted to ask you about Romania. You guys have a following in Romania. What is all that about?
Yeah. I don't know. I think that's like, that comes from piracy, probably. I don't know how else they would have gotten the record. We certainly haven't gotten any Romanian distributors.
What's your source? Because we got an email about this as well, and yeah, we got asked to play a show in Romania, and it was like, what? Yeah. Like, are you serious?
Yeah, the blue, yeah.
I mean, hopefully we get to play it.
We get lots of emails on our MySpace from Romanian blogs asking us what our favourite albums are. And then they sign off with, like, lots of love. And like, love you lots. Like, I don't know anyone in Romania who loves what.
You have to play Romania.
Yeah.
Bucharest. Yeah. There you go, yeah.